Hello, welcome back to Rush Hour. My name is Mubarak Mugabo. Now we get into the big issue of the day. Wrangles within the Uganda Journalists Association have taken a different twist after a section of journalists petitioned and sued the association together with its top leaders over alleged irregularities in the forthcoming elections. What is behind these wrangles? What is the best way of strengthening the association leadership, and also of what importance is this association to journalists? To help us digest these and more is Mathias Rukundo, the Uganda Journalist Association president and also candidate in the forthcoming elections, and also Mr. Abubakar Rubowa, the lead petitioner and also Uganda Journalist Association presidential aspirant. Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining me this morning. First of all, let me start with Mathias. When are the elections supposed to be held, and what are the qualifications or requirements for one to contest for president?
Morning, viewers. Barak, I'm glad that I'm here. It is my first time to appear on a show hosted by the singer and only Barak Mugabo, the one who chickened out from the usual practice of journalism that impacts society, but he's also here serving. I'm glad to be here.
Impacting society.
I'm glad to be here, and I'm also glad to share a platform with my friend, longtime friend, and Mr. Abubakar Rubowa, a colleague from Daily Monitor. It's been a while, not so many times that I've appeared on the show with him. I just want to put a disclaimer before I answer your question. I am a journalist professionally, and I've practiced for some good time. I have issues with the low authors that I'm seeing on the screen before me. Mm-hmm. I do not think there's anything that mounts to wrangles in Wujia. And also to want to make it clear to the viewers that there are no wrangles in Wujia.
Why are you in court?
I also want to put it clearly before you viewers, and also any journalist that is watching this show, that as the president of Uganda Journalists Association, like we said rightly so, a candidate in this process, we have not received any service of court document indicating that we have been sued in any way. So for one to say we are in court, okay, I'm also hearing it for the first time. As a professional journalist, I was taught not to take all that I see as truth. So not our lawyers, not me as an individual. So if I'm not served, I am not aware that we are even in court. But also, if it was also true that we are in court, those are simple things. People have been sued, societies have been sued, individuals have been sued, but what is true on the record, Wujia is not in court with anyone.
When are the elections supposed to be held? And now, what are the requirements for one? Because we saw quite a number of unfair requirements for somebody to actually serve.
Also, that is not true. The same is not true. Anyway, I want to be very clear. Like any other organization, there are requirements for any process for one to qualify. You and me and him knows that why we are sitting here is that just because we went to school, spent about 20 years to just qualify and be a journalist. So for anyone to belong, we must qualify. So what you call as very strict requirements, I am going to break them the simplest. One, that you're required to be a member of that association 2 years ahead of the General Assembly. Is that so big to require anyone to be a member of an association where you want to contest? No. I want to agree with you, those that are watching us, that for one, even for the family, there are guys who will tell you, abana bafemushikacha febabaita Abubakar Rubowa. You understand? So that alone, the name Abubakar Rubowa, Rubowa alone will tell you Wachikacha Mvuma, Wachikacha Lugave, and many of those things. So we all struggle in life to just qualify to be. So for one, to say that a requirement to be a member that is huge enough and is a burden enough, I think that such an issue should be
before
asked.
I bring in
but let me just explain the requirements. One of it, the most critical important requirement that was spelled out was that one must be a member 2 years ahead of the General Assembly.
Why 2 years?
This is the thing.
Because I mean, by the time you contested for Wujia president, there was no such a...
There was there!
No, there was a requirement for you to be a member, but not for 2 years.
No. This is is the thing, Mugabo. That's why I was saying you ran away from the the usual practice that qualifies you to be a member of the Uganda Journalists Association, but we regard you as one. So here's the thing. When I was contesting in 2018, when I came as the vice president of Lubowa, we were required, one, to qualify and be members. But because I was a constant participant in the elections of Wuja, that did not get me on the wrong page of the book. I was a member, and there was a requirement that you must be a member before you qualify to pay nomination fees and any other requirement. Here are the requirements. One, be a member first. Mm-hmm. 2 years ahead of that General Assembly, what the measurement wants to bring out is that they must qualify that member. That member should be close to the association. So that member should be able to understand the challenges and issues that needs to be addressed in the General Assembly. We do not, the cure of people waking up in a day and they show up to say, I am a member, on that General Assembly's day, had always brought issues of masqueraders attending these General Assemblies. Border guys showing up on that day, and they will tell you, please, I am a member of Wuja. So what it was intending to cure was that if you must be...
Before I bring in Abu, yeah. I want to read actually the court document that you say you haven't seen yet.
Can I qualify this simple point?
I have actually looked at the document. It was talking about the process leading to the decision or directive and the decision itself of the respondents, in that case, you and Wuja, communicated to the applicants on 3rd February, barring, stopping, eliminating, and ejecting the applicants from standing for elective positions in the First Respondents Association is illegal, ultra-virus, irrational, unreasonable, unfair, and abuse of the respondents' power. You do not have powers to stop any member of Uganda Journalist Association from contesting for a position in that association.
What powers do us have? What power does the Uganda Journalists Association have? If we do not have power to assess as the requirement of the constitution of Uganda Journalists Association, then which power do we hold? Here is the thing, Barack. Don't be misled by English. Here is an association of 6 years. It was founded in 1963. It has had a great journey of achievement and a great journey of failure here and there. The readership, every time a readership changes, it changes just because the previous readership has done its measurable contribution, and then the burden shifts to the current readership. For it to assess what has been the challenges of Wuja. Some of the challenges of Wuja.
No, we are going to get to that point.
You see, I want to qualify why you should not believe this. When you say that Wuja does not have a right to set guidelines.
Not setting guidelines to bar its members from exercising their
constitutional rights. Let's discuss a singular issue. What is it that the candidate present here was required to present for him to qualify?
Hold it.
Let's answer that first.
You have taken a lot of time. I want to bring in Abu. Abu, why are you fighting the association in the first place? And why are you in court?
Good morning, viewers of Urban TV. My first time to be actually also to be in the studios of Urban, but I've always been around the premises of Vision Group. I also want to thank you for hosting us, because there are so many things that are happening. When I see my brother say the tagline of issues happening around Wuja and he's trying to like wash them down, I really don't understand what he's thinking about as the association, as the sitting and outgoing president, because I believe he's going. Mm. One of the things
that I'm going.
Your term ended. You are
actually.
I must teach you these
things. No.
Let me just help
Matthias,
you.
He's been actually respectful. When you were talking, I kept quiet. Please. Thank you. Because he's the outgoing, because we are going into an election, you don't know what will come out unless you have the results. Unless you have the results. But when I say you are the outgoing, I mean it, because I know we are in court, like you said. You're asking me, why am I fighting the association. I'm not fighting the association, and I'm not fighting anyone, but I want to bring leadership. Leadership that is for all, not for a clique. You know, the challenge we have in journalism is we have created cliques. And when you create cliques, it means we need to fight the cliques. So I'm not fighting the association as the association. It's the leadership that has not served journalists the way we thought we should be served. I've had the outgoing president saying the laws are there to be made. I mean, there are guidelines that were set. Everything was set, and people didn't follow the guidelines and stuff. I want to remind him that Uja has a constitution. Anything that is done in that association is guided by the constitution. In the constitution, if there is nowhere where they say you have to be a member of the association 2 years before to the general elections, then if you bring it in as a leader, it has to be put in the, like you had to amend the constitution. So if you fail to amend the constitution, then how come that you effect these, because these one, I think they were just guidelines, but they should be, they should follow the constitution. Yes, anything that is against the constitution, whether, actually if the Uja constitution is also against the Ugandan constitution, then whatever it's doing is wrong. Any constitution that is against the Ugandan constitution, or any law, or anything subject to the constitution, has to abide by what the constitution says. So if you people are saying that the association...
just address us as leaders, don't say if you people.
Okay. If the outgoing leaders are saying that they're not following the constitution, then what are they doing in that association? Because everything that you do in the association has to be guided and has to follow the constitution. So you're doing things that you think are helping only you as individuals, but they're not helping the association. So when you say I'm fighting the association, I'm not fighting the association, but I'm fighting a leadership of cliques.
Please, Mr. Rubova. I find that below the belt, and I
maybe
cannot
can
agree.
Substantiate
please
that.
Let him do.
Because, one, if you call any other leaders of that association, okay, those who have been in power of that association, because I can say there was an election in the first place when he was coming into that leadership. There was an election.
What was there?
It was a selection.
Of what?
Of individuals.
Border guys or
just? No, of individuals.
No, let's
see, I wanted him to substantiate the other issue.
You don't actually have time to respond to that, but I want him to first make his point.
You know, but you do not make statements that belittle leaders and qualify them to be something else. And you allow me to...
Let him justify what actually he's talking about.
Okay. The leadership has to have 20... executive members.
24, by the way. Let me correct you. There are 24.
Those who are elected are supposed to be 20. Then the president
can appoint
other four members.
Mr. Obowa, the guidance of the Uganda Gents Association has a requirement that it will have 24 leaders of the executive. Please,
do you have the roadmap with you?
It shows. How
No. I'm telling you. It shows. 20.
The roadmap was against.
They must be there for regional coordinators that are appointed in the General Assembly.
Can I explain what I'm saying?
Yes.
Elective executive members are 20, and the president is given
four slots
to
appoint. It is not given. It is a requirement of the law.
Yes, that's what actually is talking about.
Yeah, but it is not given. It is a requirement of law that those positions must be fulfilled.
The president
Matthias,
to appoint actually the four members.
Matthias. I think let's listen to each other. You
don't allow you to misguide people that have.
You came with a notebook. You can write.
Let Abu actually make his point.
You can
I
write.
Want him to make
you
his
respond
point.
You respond
to the
time.
Questions that he's talking about.
So among the 20, okay, let me say the 24, like you want to put it, among the 24, It's only a group of 4 to 5 people working on each and everything. These other people were
sidelined.
Yes, exactly. We have colleagues who work with vision. We can call one of them. They can come and ascertain. But that's why I'm telling you, it's a clique.
And it does not bring
and it's not serving journalists. It's not serving.
But Abu, was there a need to go to court? Wouldn't these matters have been resolved internally?
Well, when they were setting guidelines to this election, they called for what they wanted to be. And I think it's very, very, very important to have a vetting committee.
Mm.
They called for a vetting committee. So when I took back my papers, I thought the dam taking the papers, I'll be vetted and I'll come out either knowing I'm a candidate or not,
a candidate. Mm.
We just found a gentleman seated receiving papers.
Mm.
So we're like, okay, are you the one vetting me? Is the committee constituted of only one person? Because we, personally, I expected to find, like, let me say, a panel of like 3 to 4, or even if 2. Or even if 1, the gentleman told us, I'm here to receive papers from you. So I was like, so I just give you the papers and go? He said, yes, you receive notification via email. So that's the vetting that they put. But like you said, why didn't we follow guidelines? Because personally, there are so many things that that are against what they put. Actually, they set laws that they didn't even follow themselves. They set guidelines that they didn't even follow.
Mm.
Because you ask for a degree, someone presents the papers. So how will I know that you also have a degree in journalism to be a president? If you didn't go through a vetting committee, because what I know, Matthias, you're a student of journalism now. Aren't you a student?
I have been on the road many years. I've been a student.
Thank you. So you ask for a degree in journalism. Anyway, let me not go there, because
Matthias, these allegations. There are so many allegations that are being actually labeled against your leadership that you are trying to block people from going there, and also rolling out a roadmap that is against the Wuja constitution. As actually Abu is saying, why are you trying to entrench this position? Are you now entrenching this position for a clique, as Abu is talking about?
But you see, Mubarak, I am sorry. Sometimes I get offended, because when I come for these discussions, I feel I have a platform to share information, to share knowledge, to discuss issues. Now, I am completely challenged by the insinuations made by Mr. Abu, and that qualifies why Mr. Abu needs time to get closer to the association and to educate himself how associations are governed, how leadership is set, and how does it move in motion. Now, I want to help the viewers who are following us that it is also not true that Wuja has sat aside and created guidelines that do not fit into the constitution. The requirement of Article 10 of the Uganda Journalists Association sets responsibilities for the executive committee to set guidelines for what the association will follow in all processes. So for him to imply that it's a clique of people, I want to ask the gentleman present here, does he qualify himself as the association himself? He makes another insinuation. This leadership was not elected. The gentleman chose, submitted the documents in 2020 when I was coming to contest with him. Submitted the documents, protested the figures of the IDs, all that was reviewed. The next thing we had, the man was making money at a certain trip of a certain candidate, and he felt the association should not carry its responsibility until the gentleman comes back from his assignment. That is really, really wanting of him to imagine that his absence would require the association, the entire 6-year-old association, to sit down and wait for Mr. Abu. Mr. Abu, educate yourself in the manner how leadership is required to behave, but also educate yourself that you are an individual like any other journalist from Guru, from Masaka, from where. So there's nothing special with him that would have made Wuja to sit down and doesn't hold its role requirement responsibility of organizing a general assembly so that new leadership takes position. So for that, I excuse him because he speaks from an ignorant point of view of what, I'm even shocked, he needs a lot of time to understand what the laws of Wuja shoulder responsibilities on the current leadership.
Do you feel comfortable being on a ballot paper alone without any competition?
You see, let me just
I normally don't want to intervene when someone is speaking, but the kind of language Matthias you're using is not for leaders. Thank you.
Ms. Abu, I am just helping the viewers who had not gotten an opportunity to listen to you.
The kind of language that you
but
use.
I'm just responding to what you said.
I want us to debate.
Let's
these
debate
issues.
Issues.
Because these are no, but you've just said. Matters.
When you say that you are ignorant about.
The law of the Wuja, is that a bad language? Because that is what I'm coming here to educate you about. Because when you say there was no election, and I'm telling you, the requirement of the law of Wuja required leaders to have a general assembly, and it is set on 12th December 2020. I'm just educating you about the laws of Wuja. So that if that offends you, then I don't know what to say.
We want to take a short break.
But let me just
Actually, the time is telling me. My producer is telling me that we have to take a short break. Okay. But before we actually, when we come back, there are two very important questions I want you two gentlemen to raise.
I just want to respond on requirements. Please.
And one of the questions is that it seems like every journalist who come into that association leadership. Prioritize personal gains over the interest of the leadership. What have you done in the association? But also, the allegations that Abu, you are actually being fronted by some opposition candidates and leaders in this country, and you want to turn this association into another opposition political wing of whatever politics they are playing. We are taking a short break. We are coming back in a short while. Welcome back to Rush Hour. My name is Mubarak Mugabe. Now we are in the big issue, and with me is Mr. Matthias Rukundo, the Wuja president and also candidate in these forthcoming elections, and Mr. Abu Bekar Rubowa, a journalist with the Daily Monitor, but also a lead petitioner in and also a Wuja presidential aspirant, not candidate. Before we left for a break, Matthias, you were still actually making some clarifications on the issues that Abu raised. But also I want to also to tie it in one, you know, other question of Wuja leadership has always been, you know, controversial. And also many of the journalists who come into that association prioritize their personal gains. What have you done for Wuja since you actually ascended to this office?
Okay, thank you so much, Mbaraka. And thank you, viewers, for following us. Now, when I came to office, Can I start with clarifying on the issues raised by the
judge? Because the issues that actually Abu raised, unless if there is that one that you really feel you just want to clear air
okay.
on it.
I want to be very specific. For those who share knowledge of how organizations are led on the basis of the constitutions that are put in place to manage them. These constitutions have clauses that empower the executive leadership to determine the direction and the pathway for that association. Like any other organization, Wuja has had an opportunity to have leadership. I joined office in 2020, December 12th. And since that time, we assumed office and we assumed responsibility that was too huge. The previous leadership had its challenges completely. And our leadership, when we came into office, there was a lot to do. Now, one of the achievements that we have done and we are fighting to do is to unite journalists. Uniting journalists is not a one-day decision, a one-off activity. it is a continuous activity. For those who know, for the first time, Uganda Journalists Association was able to hold a calendar activity called the World Press Freedom Day Media Gala. We did not, it should surprise you that when we joined office, we did not even find a singular account, functioning account, that you would want to imagine that any association should have at the start. We did not find a singular item, a singular anything in Uja. So we started at scratch, like from zero. So as we speak now, we've had about 20 achievements and we've made them public. Gentleman with us here knows, and we shared entirely on the platforms of journalists. Mm. The other thing was, when we held Media Gala, our question was, what is it that we can do to rebrand the image of Uganda Journalists Association? Because the image of Uganda Journalists Association is scratched by those that we have qualified in quotes enemies of Uja. Mm. And enemies of Uja
have... Who are the enemies of Uja?
Enemies of Uja are organizations that have occupied space where Uja should be playing for some time when it was weak. There are people who are very worried that in case Uja wakes up and starts functioning in its requirement of law, they will never have business to do in the sector of media.
So in other words, your major achievement is just, you know, getting the image of Uja back to its right place.
You see, we identified two challenges as we joined office. We identified that the challenge of Uja was that it had a very damaged brand image. Mm. So with a very damaged brand image, you could not approach people and they believe you. We had a 2 month consultative meeting where the gentleman present here was invited. We were asking singular questions. What is it that we can do as a sober leadership to rebrand and rebuild the association for the better good of journalists of today and those that will come tomorrow? We consulted them and they gave us their views. I appreciate him. And all those views that were corrected in that month, 2 months, we consulted the leaders, we consulted practicing journalists, many of them. We are packaged into a target of 10 key issues that we must achieve before we leave. But I want to appreciate that when we came in office in 2020, in December 12th, the next, after 1 month, on 18th March, we were put into a lockdown up to September. So we did not have much time to implement many of our objectives that we wanted to achieve.
In the reason why I asked you this question is that on Saturday, actually, you concluded a journalist symposium and you put journalists, actually, in Chambogo, where you brought NRM cadres, UPDF officers, and the vice president, the president, and you started singing, actually, the name of President Yoweri Museveni, praising him. It seems you sold this association to the National Resistance Movement.
Stop imagining, please, that the same is not true. You want me to leave the other achievements, I just bounce and explain this?
No, because I mean...
You see Mubarak. Let's stop politics. I am a leader. And the only opportunity we should allow a leader is to implement his vision. We had 850 journalists from the entire regions of Uganda. You know what that means? That speaks to the spirit of uniting journalists in Uganda. That was one of our mission. That was one of our grounds of empowering and building a member-based Uja.
By delivering Uja to State House.
It's your imagination.
Means,
I want to reiterate my position that is not true. Chambogo is not State House. But all the leaders that appeared in Chambogo are leaders of this state, this country,
there
Uganda.
There was no single civil society person. There was no single opposition politician,
please,
for example. Let me
also give information. It was not an issue of politics.
No, but
We only invited those that had the messages we wanted.
You collected National Resistance Movement leaders, all of them.
That is not true. That is not true. John Tatia Mister is a lecturer at Naija University. Kabakumba, who taught sessions, is a lecturer at Makerere University. James Rwetute, who lectured on several issues in different platforms, we were organizers. So you can't speak from your comfort zone and want to imply that we are inviting politicians only. You should have attended so that you get to know what was really fact and what is propaganda in a sense. But let me just...
You're actually taking a lot of time.
Let me just say a small thing, Mubarak. You see,
in a minute.
I am a leader of an association.
Yes.
An association that has that much value of 6 years of existence. For if you do not allow me 5 minutes straight to substantiate...
Honestly, I have given you much more time than I've given Abu. I want Abu to respond to, first of all...
But he made claims that I need really to clear.
No, but you will actually have more time. I want actually to bring in Abu. Abu, are you seeing anything good about this leadership? For example, the time it has been in existence and the actual achievements Mathias is talking about.
Any leadership has its good and bad. I can't say they have been totally bad, though they have not served to our expectations. They have tried to do things that we have already done. When he talks about the gala, for us, we had already started about this thing of moving, because we created a football, let me say, can I call it like a football club? Mm. We have a team of journalists. It's called Kampala Journalists Football something. I forgot, it has just skipped out of my mind. And that's why they got the idea of having the gala, the football gala. So
so it was your idea?
No, I'm not saying it was my idea. Mm. We have a
there's a distinction between a gala and a club, guys.
Let him speak.
We have been moving to different districts, different regions, playing football with our fellow journalists from those regions. Mm. So if someone gets them around and they play football, like in a gala, I think that's good. I'm not saying it's bad. You know, for him, he wants to show that everything that I'm saying shouldn't even be said and it's wrong and
that's
what.
That's not true.
Because I was still explaining, you just jumped in. Anyway, so that gala thing is good. We have, for me, those are the kind of things that I have in mind. So they have tried their best. I think they have reached their peak, where some of us think that shouldn't be the peak. There are so many things that should be done to unite journalists. He has explained how they went to Chambogo, brought around 800. You said 800.
It was the submission of the list was 1,600. Those that were able to arrive and attend were 850.
Yes, 850. But I think you see the will of journalists.
When you unite.
I'm not saying that the people who attended are not journalists, though we don't have evidence that they are all journalists. But the people who attended, you can see the will of journalists. You didn't attend. I'm not saying you. Those who attended are not journalists. They're journalists. But the will of people to attend was actually, I have a colleague in office who tried to call the person who was registering people, and he was told the slots were done. You get it? But this was even before the function. So they were closing out some people. There are people they wanted to attend.
Really?
No, but
they sidelined some.
Exactly.
From where?
But personally, I didn't attend because the age bracket that was required, I was above the age bracket. That's one of the reasons as why I couldn't attend. He talked about journalists being sold to the government. You know, it's good for journalists to meet the powers that be, to meet the president. It's very, very important. You saw the editors went and met the president, though I don't think they actually represented us, because they never said anything about journalism. And I have a problem with editors, by the way. They are the biggest hypocrites that we have in this media industry. They don't represent us. They went to State House and started asking very, 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 very funny questions. I'm not saying fun as in they were laughable, but anything that doesn't even help the people they represent.
Abu,
let me finish up. And when they went to Chambogo, at 5 a.m. they were doing muchaka muchaka, they were singing army songs.
Praising President Museveni.
Praising the president, being part. Actually, they were being partisan. You even asked him, were there no? You mean the leadership of the leader of opposition has no person that can come and talk to the journalists if it was a national issue of journalists? If it wasn't for NRM, if it wasn't for the UPDF, no leader from any other section, leave alone the lecturers, you were talking about empowering journalists to be rich. We didn't even see someone there who, like the people we know in economics in this country. You mean they are not there? You mean there was no someone from the office of the leader of opposition? So this is something that you guys were trying to drive, and then you come out. I know your next question is, why do I want to sell the leadership of?
This question goes to both of you, because when you look at, for example, there is a very interesting tweet from President Yoweri Museveni praising Mathias Rukundo, and of not Mathias Rukundo as a person, but the association, trying to show how journalists actually collected themselves into a group of, circles. Formed circles within themselves to empower them. That's given, and I think he will cry fire on that. But also it is alleged that, Abu, you are sponsored by the opposition. Most of the opposition politicians have already anointed you to be their candidate in this association. Why do you want to turn this association into a media wing of the opposition politicians?
Well, who alleges?
It is alleged, and actually there are many reports coming in from the circles of journalists. And
which
this
circles?
Is not the first time this is actually being alleged against
you. I want to put it clear. The first person to use that allegation was now Honorable, he's an MP,
Kazuwe Bashir, his predecessor.
Yes. That's the trick he used to see that he's helped, and then he got into power. But what I can tell you is, I've been a journalist I'm close to 11 years now, because I'm making 11 years this year around May. I've been covering all political parties, because actually I cover politics. I've covered all political parties. I've been to the State House. I've been to the home of Dr. Besigye. I've been to the home of the president of NUP. I've been to all political parties. But now, the challenge in Uganda is, because people take sides, some of us have tried to remain professional. There was a time I would cover Dr. Besigye rioting in town, and then in the evening I'm at State House covering the president. That annoyed some of the soldiers at State House, who would check my camera and then find photos of Dr. Besigye, and then the next day they see his picture on the cover, arrested and what. So, of course, I won't say I'm an enemy of the opposition, because I'm not an enemy of the government as well.
Yes,
I am a journalist who covers politics.
Yes.
So it's okay for them to put me wherever they are. Actually, even when people were trying to solicit for money to arrange this thing, they got my pictures recently.
Solicit money for the symposium?
Yes, yes.
That's quite a very serious allegation.
Because they went to State House and they were given money. Do you think the association has money to organize to feed journalists for a full week? It doesn't. Money came from State House.
I want Mathias to react.
No. Money came from State House, and it's not a crime. We pay taxes.
But you see, it is a crime when you start alleging that they used your photo when you with Bobo Wine.
No. Listen. Journalists were invited.
So in other words, for them, journalists. To be able to get
let me explain.
From State House,
let me explain.
They had to use your photo with Bobby Wine.
Exactly. That's what they did. So what I did, I shared my photos with them. I told them, please don't share only one photo. I have a photo when I was standing with, I was actually asking questions.
But you see, Mubarak,
let him.
Actually, you're going to.
I told you, you have a book. Mm. You're right.
No. But you see, there are things that you must stop at the start.
And Matthias,
for gentlemen to say that they use a picture to get capital to fund the journalists, it is something that.
Where did you get the money to fund this?
No. I have to finish. Yes, let me conclude. Mm. So if you are invited, if you are, because in this journalism circles, I am a leader in my own capacity, and people believe in what I believe in.
What does he lead?
People who believe in what I believe in, we always come to me and we discuss. Why did you, if you say, what do I lead? Why did you come to me?
You said you were a leader.
No. When you're making consultations, why didn't you go to
you
any
journalist. You were a senior journalist in the country. We
and that makes
you.
Him a
and
leader.
That makes me a leader.
No. Yes, the definition of leadership is different.
I want
to so, no, no, let me.
First of all, on the question of using your picture.
So, when. No. Let me first allegation. Finish up. Mm. So, I shared my pictures. There's a picture I have when I was asking some questions to Jeno Muhoz. I told them, please use these ones as well. Don't use only one picture. There is a picture, actually the president called me himself to take a picture with him. I told him, please use this one as well. Don't use only one picture.
So
these people, I want to assert it, that these people use my picture to say that the person they want to bring in wants to take the leadership. That's why they even sent you that question. That I want to.
You can imagine. They sent you a question.
No. So I got this question from at least a Wuja member.
Yes.
And the Wuja member was telling me that Abu is the opposition candidate, Matthias is the NRM candidate. And what I saw in the symposium, I don't want to believe that you were an NRM candidate in Wuja elections.
But you see, Mubarak, this is why for me, I think you need to accord me some good time to really leverage the discussion from Rugambo, here says, to issues that really matter for Wuja and for a community called journalists.
Go ahead.
One, it is not true that a photo taken
with
Chagulanyi,
with Chagulanyi, Abu and Chagulanyi,
where Abu was attending a party,
yeah,
which is rightly
I attended,
which is rightly okay, can be used as a security in a bank or to an individual to qualify billions of money to come to Wuja and to be paid to journalists. That is impossible, and you would be insane
Abu,
to believe
let,
it. Let me just finish.
Please. Money to Abu. Organize the symposium.
Let me just conclude my point. You would be insane to even come closer to believing that a photo of Abu, a journalist like any other, a photographer at that, in the remonta can be used as security by Wuja leadership to go and apply for a donation, and that picture qualifies into an asset for guaranteeing money to be paid to journalists. Please, the same is not true. And Abu, please, if you must be, please avoid those.
Let me just go slowly.
So it is not true.
Yes, it is not true.
I do not want even to discuss it.
Where did you get the money to organize this symposium?
Mubarak, one of the mission I embarked on as a leader is that I looked and read into the welfare of journalists, me being one of them. And my two core objective is that if God allowed me to create an opportunity where journalists can get mentorship about financial literacy, abilities to look at our profession as an opportunity, not just to die poor, but also change the financial standing of journalists. That was my core objective. And that does not come in a day, like I said. I have approached many agencies, and they have conducted several engagements and discussions and trainings for journalists. One of the issues that I had to break was the issue.
Where did you get the money?
You're a moderator now.
No.
Let him answer so that we go into other issues.
To that question. Yes.
So Mubarak, okay, because of the time I can run and speak to what you guys want to hear, but I always want to give you the background and what was the motivating points to get to where we are. I approached a government of the Republic of Uganda, presented a document to them. I asked them, I am a leader of a very huge, I mean, the small group, huge and small, and I intentionally mean it. I would want to, this group to be taught how to generate wealth in their career. Mm. I presented to them that Uganda Genesis Association, as an association, would want that to be done. But in our abilities or financial incapacities, we cannot have that done. I gave a proposal. We presented before different boards of government. We presented before the Uganda, the wealth creation team. We presented to many of them and said, okay, President, what is it that you want us to do that can save you? I said to them, guys, if you can get funding to facilitate such a session, I'll be grateful. And I want to appreciate the government of Uganda.
Who funded specifically?
The government of Uganda.
Through who?
Through, what do you mean through?
The government. I mean, there must be an institution that funded this symposium, Mathias.
Mubarak, I am
who
speaking.
Is it Mr. Museveni who funded this symposium? Is it Honorable Chris Bariomusi? Is it the UPDF? Is it, who exactly funded this symposium?
Are those the bodies of government of Uganda?
No, I mean, government of Uganda is abstract. You cannot just say it's government of Uganda. Even if it's government of Uganda.
And you see, you did not even allow me to finish. Okay, let me just finish and speak to what you want to hear, because I do not like those small things. I always want to go to big things. So when they concluded on that and they said, okay, fine, how can we do it? I said, no, just get a place around. I asked them to pay for.
But you're talking about them. I want to
I said the government of Uganda is headed by the President of the Republic of Uganda, President Yoweri Museveni, but through an agents of State House.
Uh-huh.
State House pledged contribution, financial contribution,
yes,
to facilitation of the sessions.
So it's State House that facilitated.
Contributed to facilitation. Listen.
Mathias, you are the president of Uganda.
And I'm speaking as one.
Yes, so I don't want you to sound like as if you didn't know where the funding came from.
So do we have distinctive governments in Uganda? Do we have State House and government?
No, but still the president is presiding over a very big government, and of course there are different institutions.
So what is your
take? There must be an institution that must have funded this symposium.
Is also that
I want you to specifically tell the public who exactly funded this symposium. Is it Operation Wealth Creation, Namukekera? Is it State House as it is?
Journalists
out there are asking these questions.
They are not asking.
You are the president.
They are not even asking questions because I was with them. They know how we received. By the way, the same is not even true that we are funded. We were facilitated for the sessions of 5-6 days of training. So funding is a wrong word.
And
it is not even applicable.
500,000 shillings at the end of the day.
If the president of the association felt that any journalist wanted, because of the time they committed and off their duties of work, where they earn a living,
uh-huh,
and in my wisdom, convinced my partners that let's facilitate these young girls, boys, who have left their work for the commitment of knowledge gathering. You want to make also that something that is not worth it? It is facilitation. Granted, in consultation with Wuja and our partners, so that shouldn't be your business. I am a leader. I am a leader that is on. Let me just speak on about two things.
In a second,
Barak, you see, when you host someone who is a leader of a valuable association, I want to speak to three things. One, I want to ask my friend Abu that if you want to be a leader of Uganda Journalists Association, there are requirements for you to qualify to be. Secondly, if you want to be a leader of this association, you must not be seen as a person.
Let me just
finish this. A person who wants to fight the association you want to lead, for one to be required to be a member.
This place. Anyway,
and that offends Mr. Abu. We are sorry, everyone must be a member of Uja to qualify and participate in all activities.
What is the way forward, Abu?
You know, I'm not a person who wants to fight to be seen that I'm doing something. I'm one person who always want my work to speak for myself. That's why I'm a photographer, like he said.
I take pictures
that speak for what
I do. And I write stories
and
with qualified ingredients.
Mathias,
we are actually running out of time.
Let me conclude with this. Mm. I don't want to interject him when he's speaking, but
no,
actually
see,
you've given him a lot of time.
Even my advantage point as a leader, he must speak.
No,
and also, I must guide...